Hey everybody, I need to replace the timer on my old washing machine, and I only need a couple of screwdrivers and a small ratchet and socket to do it. Before I do anything though, it's important that I unplug the washing machine. On this old washing machine, there's a couple of screws on top. We're going to have to take those off so that we can access the back of the front panel. If you're wondering how I came to the conclusion that the timer was the problem in my washer, I put some information in the description of this video that you can read. It might be helpful. Now that the screws are removed, the front panel just it simply tilts forward. As you can see, there's not a whole lot going on here. We have the water level control and the temperature control. There's a small fuse right here. And then there's the brains of the washing machine, the timer. There's a part number on this timer. That'll be helpful when it's time to buy a new timer. Now, before we can get the old timer out, we have to take the cycle control knob off. So let's pop this cover off using a small screwdriver. Underneath the cover is this clip. Depress the knob, slide the clip off. Behind the knob, there's a spring. Don't lose it, or your day will be ruined. Now let's remove the dial. And behind the dial, there's 20 years of dirt. So let's remove that as well. Now the timer is attached using these two screws. So I'll use my small socket and ratchet to remove the screws. This is a real easy job, and not one of you guys ought to be intimidated by this type of job. If you're not used to making repairs like this, this would be a good first-time job to build confidence. As you can see, the timer is now detached from the control panel. We still have to remove the wiring harness. It's just a plug, just just grab it, wrestle with it. It'll come out. Now, thanks to the part number that was on the back of the timer, I was able to locate an exact replacement. The new timer is on the right. It's got the same part number. And it certainly looks identical. So I'm pretty confident that I've got the right one. So let's plug it in. Now let's position the timer so that we can start the screws. Just use my socket and extension to snug the screws up. After that, I'll put my ratchet on and torque it down. Now, these are small screws. So don't tighten them too much, or you'll ruin your day. Let's position the control panel and tilt it back into position. And let's reinstall the screws that hold the control panel in place. This is, like I said, this was a real easy job. And it's a very satisfying job. Let's put the dial back on. It's only going to go on one way because of this crazy looking pin that's sticking out of the timer shaft. So just slide it on and rotate it. It'll fall right into place. Now next, take the knob and make sure you've got that spring. And slide it on. Everything looks good. Now depress the knob so that you can reinstall that small tab that holds the knob. Looking good. Now let's just put that small cover back on. There's some tabs that need to line up with the knob. But once you do that, it just pops right back on. Now turn the timer to the off position. Now let's plug the washing machine back in. I'm going to turn this thing to a normal load. Here we go. Bingo. Let's put some detergent in and wash a load of clothes. Thanks for watching.